What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be talking about Revit's user interface. So I'm going to be showing you just how you can set everything up. There isn't too many settings, but there are some important settings, and then more importantly, if you lose something, if you lose some of the tools, some of the panels, I'm just going to be showing you where they are and how you can turn those back on. Now before we jump into Revit, if you're a complete beginner, I would like to recommend you check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description and then also up in the cards above. There you can find my complete beginner to intermediate level course, where I go slowly step by step and explain pretty much everything you need to know to get started working on your own projects in Revit. In addition to that, you can find the rest of my courses, where I cover some of the more advanced or intermediate topics. You can find some of my customized, ready-to-go Revit templates. You can find some really high-quality Revit families, as well as a plugin. So make sure to check that out. Also, before we get started, make sure to like this video. It helps me out a lot. And make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of my future videos. Okay, now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. You can see this is a kind of a complete project of a house. This is just something that I have created in one of my courses, which is available on my website, as I said. And now let's start exploring the user interface. So I'm just going to start from the kind of complete top here. And then here we have something that's called a quick access toolbar. So the quick access toolbar, well, as the name would imply, is just all of the tools that you're going to require kind of quickly on the move. So all of those are going to be available here. Now, if you want to add some tools to the quick access toolbar, you can. So you can just come to one of the tools, you can right click, and then you can add that to the quick access toolbar just by clicking like this, and then it's just going to appear over here. Now, if you add too many tools, as we have right now, instead of having them just kind of laid out here, you're going to get these kind of couple of arrows, and then that tool is going to be available here, which kind of defeats the purpose of the quick access toolbar. So make sure to not have too many. Then you can just right click on that tool again here on the quick access toolbar, and then you can just remove it if you don't want it. In addition to that, you can expand this menu here, so it's customized quick access toolbar, so you can just customize what you want to have here from the tools. So by default, you're going to get all of these. So you have new, open, save, synchronize, undo, redo, print, and so on. And then if you want to have some different tools, of course, you can have those on, just finding them here and then putting them. Or if you want to remove some of these, you can just uncheck them. And now, as you can see, the text tool is gone, and then we can bring it back by checking that on, and there we go, we have the text tool. Now here what you'll see is that you can also go to the customize quick access toolbar. So this option allows you kind of further customization, where you can actually add these dividers. So if you click anywhere, you can see that you can actually add a divider or a separator, or you can move these up and down on the list. So if you have kind of a special way that you want to represent this quick access toolbar, you can customize that here. Also, you'll see the show quick access toolbar below the ribbon. So some people don't like the fact that it's over here. So what they can do is they can just go and show it below the ribbon. So it's just going to appear here below the ribbon. Some people have been contacting me, telling me that their quick access toolbar is here and they don't like it. And I tend to agree. I don't like it here, because then when you select some of the items, then the kind of the let's start a new command. Okay, so like this. So you get this kind of info panel or info line below, or the modify tab, the extension of it below the quick access toolbar. So it's kind of modify, then the quick access toolbar, then modify again. So just doesn't make sense. So I like to keep it up. So you can just expand here, show above the ribbon, and we're back there where it should be. Okay, so that kind of covers the quick access toolbar. So now let's talk about the rest of this thing. So what you'll see here is that we have a couple of panels. So we have the properties panel, and then below that we have the project browser. Now they're laid out like this by default, but you can actually move them. So if you come to the project browser, hold and then you can move it. And then, for example, what a lot of people like to do is they like to have it on the other side of the screen. So you would have your project browser on one side, the properties panel on the other side. So it's just a longer list, especially if you're working with more complex projects, you want to have more kind of screen real estate for the project browser and for the properties panel. And then, of course, the screen is a little bit smaller, kind of the window, the main window. In addition to that, what you can do is you can bring this back, and then if we can bring it down below like this, kind of dock it below, or we can dock it here on top. So what this will do is it will introduce these tabs. So you can kind of switch in between your project browser and your properties panel. So if you like that approach, you can do that, or you can just kind of select it here and then, okay, I've accidentally canceled it, but that's okay. Let's close this one as well. And now we just have a big window with no project browser and with no properties panel. So at this point, you might be panicking, but that's okay. No worries. You just want to go here to the view panel. You want to go to the user interface, and then you can bring back your properties panel, and you can bring back your project browser. In addition to that, you can see some additional panels that are available. So you have your system browser, you have your MEP for fabrication parts, the PNID modeler, and so on. And also you have your status bar, your status bar for work sets, and your status bar for design options. So that's basically referring to this bottom bar on the bottom of the screen. So if you want to uncheck any of those, you can. And for the ones that are already checked off, those you would usually need if you're working on a certain type of project. So in this case, we don't really need these. Then here you have your project browser organization, where you can actually organize how your project browser works. I'm not going to cover that right now. Also keep in mind that you can get to that by right-clicking here on Views All, and then you have your project browser organization. As I said, I'm not going to cover this because I already have a video on this topic, and I'm just going to be linking it up in the cards above. So anyways, let's now move forward, and then here we have these, again, on the window panel, here we have some windows. So you have the switch windows, and then you can switch to an additional, one of the other windows that you have. Here we only have two, so it doesn't make too much sense, but imagine if you had like a ton of these opened up, and then you can just kind of quickly find them, especially sometimes they don't fit, or they're too small to read the entire name, so you can always come here and then pick out the one that you want to use. Also, you can close all of the inactive windows just by this, by clicking on close. And then if you have more of these, let's again open up a few. So this is what, 3, 4. Okay, so if you open up more of these, what you can do is you can tile those windows. So it's just going to tile them like so, and then you can kind of view more of them at the same time. This can be useful in some cases, it's worthless in other cases, so it's really up to you. And then also you can just kind of grab one of them, and then you can kind of tab them on one tab. You can have more of them, you can have one big one and then two smaller ones, you can just have two smaller ones, two big ones like this, or you can tab them back, so it's just going to go back to this kind of tabbed view. So you have all of those options, and then let's close the inactive windows. So if you want to play around with your windows, you can do that here. And then also here, see the switch windows option that's available here. It's also available on the quick access toolbar next to the close all inactive windows. So you don't actually have to be on the view tab to access these two tools. You can find them here, which is really useful. Okay, moving forward. So next, I'm just going to be talking about some customizations in terms of the ribbon itself. You don't really get too much customization for the ribbon. It's pretty basic, really. But what you can do is you can go here to the file menu, go to the options, And then under user interface, as you can see, some of the tools and analysis you can actually turn off. So for example, if you're not using the structure tab, you can turn the structure tab off so you don't see those tools. So if you're just an architect, you can just turn every one of these apart from the architecture tab off. Obviously, your modify, your manage, your view tab, your collaborate tabs, they're all going to stay there. You can't really turn those off, but that's because you really need them. Moving forward, you also have the option to display the contextual tab on selection. So what this basically means is that if I have this turned on, that means that if I select a wall, it's going to automatically jump to the modify and then walls tab, where I have all of the tools for modifying walls. However, if I were to go and uncheck this, so let's find it here, okay. Now, if I select that same wall, it's still going to activate the Modify Walls tab. It's just not going to jump to it, so I would have to go to that here. In most cases, I think it's really useful to have this turned on. I don't really know why do we have the option to turn it off, but you have that. Moving forward, let's then go to graphics, here. You also have the option for the visual experience, so it can be a light or dark. So it's just dark here. And then speaking of dark, if you actually want it to feel more like AutoCAD, you can do that by changing the background from white to black. So it's just going to look like this. So if you want this, if you find this cool, you can do that. Obviously, still the bowels are going to stay kind of lighter. So perhaps this doesn't make any sense. I think they're working on it. If I understand correctly, kind of complete dark mode is going to be available soon, but for now we don't really have that inside of Revit. And then of course, if you want to kind of fix it back, you can just go to graphics and switch this back to white, and then to user interface, let's go with light, because it doesn't really change much. Okay, we're back. And there we go. So I hope you have learned something new. We have covered kind of all of the basic settings in terms of the interface and how you can set up the interface in order to kind of work more efficiently in Revit, how you can customize everything to your liking and customize perhaps some of the tools you need more often to be here and available at all times. If you want to get access to this project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find those on my Patreon page. So I'm going to be including a link to that in the description of this video below and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.